Did I ever want to be a cowboy? Yeah, I think when I was little I did. And I think after I started seeing all the Clint Eastwood's movies, I definitely did, so sure. My life philosophy is go big or go home. As a little kid, I was obsessed with monsters. Most parents leave the lights on for their kids so they won't be afraid of the dark, but I think secretly I wanted there to be something in my closet. I wanted there to be something living under my bed, and I would pray with all of my heart every morning that God would turn me into a werewolf. And of course, 25 years later, I get cast as a werewolf and I get to be one every day, so. Someone that comes from a classical theater background. Now I'm on a show where I'm most well known for running around in the woods with my butt hanging out. I actually spoke to one of my old professors from drama school and asking me if all of that Chekhov training has really paid off. That's cool. I've never had as much fun as I've had on True Blood. I love the character, love the show, love the cast, love the writers. What keeps people coming back and what keeps the ratings ballooning is the fact that we're talking about being human. And it's interesting that sometimes people are offended by the amount of sex on the show or its graphic nature, but most of it isn't anything that these people don't do within the confines of their house. We're just doing it in front of a camera, which, you know, is a whole other story in and of itself. Let's pretend it's not. I can only eat one thing for the rest of my life. I would have whoever the head chef of Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles. Like, I'd have them live at my house with the waffle maker on, just cooking with the special recipe chicken. It's always got a bite for me. Not every time your lips meet mine. Sexy to me is confidence. I think it's just how you carry yourself and how you make it work for you.